They say that freedom is a constant struggle. They say that freedom is a constant struggle. They say that freedom is a constant struggle. Oh Lord, we've been struggling so long, we must be free. We must be free. We must be free. Lord, we must be free.
The voice you're hearing belongs to Matt Jones, one of the original freedom singers in the early 60s, and someone who's written many, many freedom songs, and someone who's done a lot of important social justice work in this town in the last 30-some-odd years. Welcome to Songs of Freedom.
Now, I'm glad to be here.
Matt, we're here tonight to celebrate the career and life of Sis Cunningham, and we're joined from left to right by Eric Levine, Gina Talamsa-Galoon, Fred Stanton, Tom McClellan. We have a lot of talent here tonight, but why are we here? Who's Sis Cunningham, and what's her place in American folk music?
Well, Sis Cunningham is probably one of the greatest women in the folk movement. We don't know that much about her because she wrote music and she put out Broadside, but she was also a great, great musician and a great, great songwriter. Some of the songs she wrote really dealt with the issues. You know, those of us who have experienced her music know how much her music dealt with the issues. And I'm so happy that we are able to give a tribute to her, to talk about her, because it's long needed and it's long deserved for Sis.
Now, there's a show going to take place in just a couple of days at the Ethical Culture Society here in New York. You want to talk about that and who's going to be there?
Well, I don't know exactly all the people who are going to be there, but I know that Tom McClellan is going to be there. He's been working with Sis for a long, long time and really, really has supported her for years. Eric is going to be there. I think Fred, you're going to be there. Pete Seeger will be there. And Izzy Young, a man who used to MC things years ago, is going to be there. And lots of people. I mean, the who is who and the folk world will be there. I wouldn't be surprised if Bob Dylan or somebody showed up.
Mr. Zimmerman himself.
Mr. Zimmerman, that's right, himself.
Notwithstanding, folks, show up for this. It's going to be a real treat, and it's certainly well deserved. Why don't you sing us a song to get this show started?
I'm going to sing a song called When I Was Young, because Sis has been in this struggle so long, and you have to have a lot of power within yourself to stick with this struggle. Well, sometimes this movement eats you, so you have to be in good enough shape to work on and on. And I found out that what's going on today, I thought when I was young we wouldn't have this problem, but we still have the same problems today that we had years ago. When I was young, I fought for freedom. When I was young, I fought the Klan. Who would have thought, Lord, I'd still be fighting? 30 or 40 years down the line, when I was young, I fought for justice. When I was young, I fought for peace. Who would have thought, Lord, I'd still be fighting? 30 or 40 years down the line, freedom, fighting for freedom. 30 or 40 years down the line, when I was young, I fought for unions. When I was young, I fought to vote. Who would have thought I'd still be fighting? 30 or 40 years down the line, when I was young, I fought for housing.
when I was young. I fought for jobs. Who would have thought I'd still be fighting? 30 or 40 years down the line. Freedom, fighting for freedom. 30 or 40 years down the line. When I was young, I fought segregation. When I was young, I fought Jim Crow. Who would have thought I'd still be fighting 30 or 40 years down the line? Freedom, fighting for freedom. 30 or 40 years down the line. When I was young, when I was young, I fought for children. When I was young, I fought for love. Who would have thought I'd still be fighting 30 or 40 years down the line? Freedom, fighting for down the line. Freedom, fighting for freedom. 30 or 40 years down the line. 30 or 40 years down the line. 30 or 40 years down.
Yeah. Good, good. So we have to stick with it.
That's what Sis was all about. She's even fighting even today.
30, 40 years down the line.
No, no. One time I did it in a group of senior citizens. They said, look, man, it's really 60 or 70 years down the line.
70 years down the line.
30 or 40 for me. But for Sis, we're talking 60 or 70 years down the line.
I've got in my hand a flyer about this concert. Sis Cunningham, there are a lot of names here, some that you might even recognize. November 2nd at 3 o'clock, the Ethical Culture Society Hall, 2 West 64th Street. That's the corner of Central Park West. And, well, we don't usually mention prices on here, but it's $15 at the door, $10 for seniors. Don't let that be an excuse. Please be there. Eric Levine, I think you're next. You and Gina are going to play a little something for us.
Yeah, well, we want everyone out there to guess what this song is, first of all. I don't know, maybe you've heard it. If it is, you should know that it came into the culture through Broadside magazine. Bob Dylan wrote it. He was sitting in Sis's living room. He wasn't sitting in the living room, but he came into her living room. He sang it. And what did Sis say, Fred?
Bob, that's quite a song.
And then there she did. She went up, she transcribed it like she did so many other people's songs. And pretty soon it was in Broadside magazine. As a matter of fact, Sis told me that Peter, Paul, and Mary didn't sing it for about a year until it had been in Broadside for at least a year. So not only did that song come through Broadside, but, well, just to give you an example of what came through Broadside, Rambling Boy, Little Boxes, With God on Our Side, The Power and the Glory, Changes, Now That the Buffalo's Gone, Beans in My Ears, To Be a Man, The Ballad of Ira Hayes, Thirsty Boots, Society's Child, Brother That Ain't Good, Everybody's Got a Right to Live. We checked this all on the phone with Sis to make sure we were right, but they're all of them were started with Broadside magazine. Hey, can we sing one?
Why don't we sing one?
Yeah, that's great. You know, we were thinking about this one, Rambling Boy, written by Tom Paxton. we just knew we had to sing it when we were harmonizing so great back in the back there. So you sing it with us. It's got an easy chorus. Here's to you, my rambling boy.
Must have been a young man when Broadside entered your life. How did that happen?
Well, I was browsing in a bookstore downtown in Philadelphia, and I saw a magazine that had the kind of music that I was trying to write. So I started to send songs up to New York to Sis Cunningham and Gordon Friesen, who were editing the magazine, and they started sending me back letters with good advice on how to write better songs. And after a while, I went up and visited them a few times and played in a hoot to help raise money for the magazine. So that's how I met them.
By the way, who else was on that hoot docket? Who else was playing that?
A young woman named Janet Fink, who later changed her name to Janice Ian. Tom Paxton, Buffy St. Marie for some of them, the people who played.
I'm impressed.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah.
Good show.
Why don't you play us one?
All right, this is a relatively new song. One of the things that Sis and Gordon used to talk about that I identified with was their experience going through the witch hunt of the 1950s. Gordon Friesen was a very talented writer, newspaper writer. And when the McCarthy witch hunt came in the United States, he was blacklisted and never got another job writing for a paper. And it was inspiring to see that the radical movements of the 1960s brought these people a whole new generation that they could work with and bring into politics. So this is a song that when I sing it, I sometimes think of Sis and Gordon and what they went through and what my parents went through.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fred Stanton.
Here's to the prisoners of shyness, drowning in silent streams. It's a place I know I sometimes go to find technicolor dreams. Don't be afraid of the silence. Run away from the silences. You can stay a while in the silences and come back loud and strong. Come back loud and strong. To the prisoners of violence, dragging steel across the floor. We cannot sing, we are whispering just before a union is born. Don't be afraid of the silence. Don't run away from the silences. You can stay a while in the silences and come back loud and strong. Come back loud and strong. To the prisoners of silence who make words dance with our hands, with rhymes in our eyes and music in our minds, we need no ears to understand. All the sound and fury means nothing. You can't hear a single heart. Every answer begins with a question, and every anthem starts with a sigh. Don't be afraid. The silences, don't run away from the silences. You can stay a while in the silences and come back loud and strong. Come back.
Tom, what's your association with Sis? I met you for the first time at the People's Music Network gathering this past summer, and you were playing guitar while Sis performed. How far back do you go in this?
Well, I first met Sis in 1986 at a People's Music Network, and it was a broadside meeting, and I volunteered to be a volunteer, and it so happened that Sis was going to a coffee house that Matt had opened up called Open House Coffee House, and Sis asked me to that she needed somebody to accompany her for some of her songs she was writing, and we just started to collaborate from there. And she wrote a lot of wonderful songs. I would like to do one of her songs.
Well, you're not going to leave her unless you do. So why don't you play one of her songs?
I sure will. This is a song, it's called The Huddled Masses, and it's taken from a poem by Emma Lazarus that is at the foot of the Statue of Liberty. And Sis's daughter, Jane, had wrote a poem from that, and Sis put the words to music. Welcome to New York, my friend. Welcome to my town. There's Times Square and Fifth Avenue and the subway underground. The Brooklyn Bridge, the Empire State, festivals galore. And don't forget Miss Liberty, queen of our nation's lore. Torchlights shining out to sea to guide fire ships to our shore. Look around, my traveling friend, as you take in the sights. The colors on the marquee and the flashing Broadway lights. And as you walk the corridors of the Port Authority, can you fail to notice there, amid the day's debris, the tired, the poor, the cast-offs, who've no other place to be? What, my fellow citizen, what is it you see? Do you see the huddled masses yearning to breathe? As you take your noonday stroll, do you meet the outstretched hands, the swollen feet and bundled rags, and you wonder how they stand? Hungry children in the doorways, kids without a school, for if they have no place to live, school's against the rules. Is this civilization, or is the nation run by fools? Who is he, that bent old man, so tattered and distraught? And who is she, the sister, whose life efforts came to naught? Have you gazed upon Miss Liberty and seen her shed a tear for the broken hearts, the hopeless dreams, the hunger, the despair? Are the thousands of life battles lost too much for her to bear? What, my fellow citizen, what is it you see? Do you see the huddled masses yearning to breathe free? forefathers found a place to call their very own. When you were born, you had it good, and now that you are grown, you've come to see the very place beside the golden door, where those before you had arrived so wretched and so poor. While some came with a fortune and were welcomed at the shore. America is beautiful, that's what we're always told. For one who holds a silver spoon, the streets are paved with gold. A lucky star may light the way to opportunity, but the star might blink and cease to shine, and there is no guarantee that a cardboard box won't someday be a home for you or me. What, my fellow citizen, what is it you see? Do you see the huddled masses yearning to breathe free? Hurry, hurry, hurry back to your own safety zone. Forget the ugly thought that you could be without a home. Yet wrap secure in your four walls these steps you may retrace, and begin to ponder just how human is the human race. Dinner from a garbage can is a tough scene to erase. What, my fellow citizen, what is it you see? Do you see the huddled masses yearning to breathe free? Yearning to breathe free.
That was Tom McClelland. November 2nd, 1997. That's coming up in a couple of days. 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Ethical Culture Society Hall, 2 West 64th Street. Please be there. It's going to be such a great show. Eric Levine, Gina Talamsa-Galoon, Fred Stanton, Matt Jones, Tom McClelland. I'm Joe Landy. This is Songs of Freedom, and this was the quickest half hour of my life. So, for all of us here, to everyone everywhere.
Thank you.
Thank you. And you know, they say that freedom is a constant struggle.
There's a man inside you talking.